Shabbat shalom. Good Shabbos. Welcome. We are here on a very special evening to celebrate the last 10 years with Olivier Ben Chaim as the rabbi of Beit Aleph. And so, yes, you can. I think it's kosher to clap. We're beyond reform, and we can do what we want. Okay. Members of the community are participating this evening to share some thoughts. And Olivier and I did map out the music for this evening to make sure that we picked his favorite songs, which we narrowed down to 50, and then I had to just whack until we got it down to what we needed to get it down to. So the very first song, this poor microphone, the very first song we're gonna sing is on page 16, Ahava Rabbah, and yes, this was one of those favorites of the favorite songs from Olivier. Maestro, I think we want a little help up here.
Ahava Rabbah, Ahava Rabbah, Ahava Rabbah, my distinct honor and pleasure to welcome all of you to our Shabbat service tonight on behalf of the Bet Aleph Board. We are so lucky and so blessed as a community to have Rabbi Olivier as our spiritual leader. I talked to Olivier about the things I wanted to say about him, and you know, everyone who knows him well knows that he doesn't like a lot of attention focused on him. And he pointed out to me, not only is it Olivier's 10-year ordination anniversary, and we've been so lucky to have him, but Aleph has also celebrating its 25th year anniversary this year. So when you think about what holds our community together and what matters most to us and what brings us into all of these beautiful energies of Shabbat, we all see one beautiful face, and that is our rabbi. There are no words to thank you for everything you do for us. You bring us through the high times, you help us through the low times, and you give us the strength to go through these times. And we couldn't be more grateful to you. So I didn't want to say a lot of things that I know all of you will say to him. You have plenty of time to do it. But what I wanted to do tonight was welcome Rabbi Olivier, his beautiful wife, Amy, his gorgeous children, Amalia and Lior, to celebrate Shabbat together as a family with all of us at Bet Aleph. You know you are in good hands. So with that, I want us all to take a deep breath. Welcome Shabbat. And all of us who are lighting candles, you can make your way up here. And tonight, I want to remind you who our tzedakah is to. We should have a box, which I believe is in the back corner. This is another month where we are donating money to an organization called Peace for the Streets by Kids from the Streets. It is an organization that does great work in our local community with homeless at-risk youth and young adults. They really do everything they can to help those kids lead a more positive and self-sufficient life. And one of the things that a lot of people don't know about them, you know, kids don't really like to go to shelters in part because they can't bring their animals. And this organization actually provides dog food and allows you to keep your support animals with you. So if you have anything in your pockets, you know this is our tradition, please put it in our tzedakah box. And for those of you who are lighting candles, come up and light candles.
Forgot to remind, so my apologies, Joel.
So before we go through the list in our community, and you know, this is a really special time at Bet Aleph where we share everything that's happening in our lives, what's going well, what we want to remember, some of the harder times, things that are happening that are meaningful. And this is how we connect with each other. And Rabbi Olivier is so good at this part, so good at it, and Tracy's going to try. But one of the things I was thinking before we start, he's walked so many of us through a candle lighting service. So just take 1 minute and think about the things Olivier has helped you both celebrate and remember. There are many in 10 years. And we love him for it. Okay, so we're gonna do our best. We're gonna start farthest away from me, and that is where I see Paula Chester Leibes. And Paula is lighting in memory of her mother, Mickey Leibes, in honor of her 17th Yahrzeit, and she often feels her strength supporting her. And we have the one. You guys are never in the order. Ah, John and Pat Hoagland. There they are. They're lighting in celebration of their 47th wedding anniversary. Mazel tov. And next we have Ellen and Michael Lyons, and they're lighting in honor of Ellen's cousin, Peter Lazar. Today would have been his 36th birthday. He had an avalanche not taken him at the end of February in Bozeman. May your spirit soar with the eagles and our ancestors. Primo, go ahead, play with this flame if you want. And next to them, we have Greg Siegler, and he's lighting in memory of his father, Dr. Peter Siegler, in honor of his 6th Yahrzeit. And next, we have Rachel Soffren and Joshua Blattman. There you go, I know you, Josh. And they're lighting in memory of her grandfather, Bennett Marks, as well as her mother, Marion Soffren, in honor of their Yahrzeits. And to celebrate and share about Josh's showcase performances this Wednesday night. So I'm sure Josh will tell you more about those. And then we have Lynn Carroll, and Lynn Carroll is lighting in celebration of her 75th birthday. Mazel tov, Lynn. And next we have Jan Simon. You guys are all, you have no idea how much shorter you are until you stand here. And Jan is lighting in memory of her mother, Harriet Simon, in honor of her 25th Yahrzeit. We have Susan Hoffman. Susan is lighting in celebration of a 5-year journey to physical health after suffering from back problems since March 2010 after a magnificent hike in Leavenworth. And next we have Ricky Levin and John Dorschick. They're lighting a candle in celebration of their 4th wedding anniversary and also the best wedding ceremony they've ever experienced, thanks to Rabbi Olivier. And they are also lighting in memory of John's dad, Hugh Dorschick, in honor of his 3rd Yahrzeit. And next we have Shelley Cohen. He's lighting to celebrate a speedy recovery from falling down the stairs last night, but he's sore and still intact. He is also writing to honor our beloved rabbi for his column, Judaism in Death and Dignity, in this week's issue of Real Change. So we appreciate that too. And then we have Joel Feldman, who is lighting a candle in memory of his mother, Ruth Duskin Feldman, in honor of her Yahrzeit. So with that, that's how our community gets to know each other. So I'd like you to join me on page 1. Where we will read the prayer to bless the Shabbat light.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kirshanu b'mitzvotav. Yes.
Well, I was remiss to not write down the page number for this next song, but it's a hallelujah, which means it starts with an A, which means it should be at the beginning, somewhere near the beginning. Well, Mike's going to look it up for us.
Page 15.
All right. We went from 16 to 15. Big leap. And if you feel so moved to get up and dance, and if you're not going to get up and dance, dance on the inside, okay? Hallelujah, Bechayai. Hallelujah, Bechayai. Hallelujah, Bechayai. Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Nafshi Etya, Hallelujah, Nafshi Etya, Hallelujah, Nafshi Etya, Hallelujah. Hazara little high will be, Hazara little high will be, Hazara little high will be. Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Nafshi Etya, Hallelujah, Nafshi Etya, Hallelujah, Nafshi Etya. Big finish. Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
Yeah, we got a lot to do tonight, so.
I don't like champagne, and I find that I like the one that we have downstairs, so bear with me if I, whatever. Okay. All right, so the Baruch Hu and the Shema are coming up, right? So we, Baruch Hu, we bless and bless and bless. 100 times a day, we Jews, well, you know, observant ones anyway, are supposed to mouth all those blessings. And among those, the Shema, those six little words we repeat over and over, literally until we die. You know, that central affirmation of our people, it's so easy to fall into rote unconsciousness and get lost in the repetitive, unending busyness of our lives as a whole, or a, you know, kiss the mezuzah kind of Judaism. And so this made me think of a current obsession of mine, well, of ours actually, that I'd like to share with you in a word. Shtissel. So, commercial break. How many of you know what I'm talking about? Yeah, Erie's. You have to know. Yeah. Okay, so. Well, all right, so if you don't, do yourself a favor, find a friend who has Netflix and binge watch the entire two seasons of this Israeli phenomenon. It's truly remarkable. So, here's the thing about Shtissel. It's gorgeous, unassuming, surprising show that follows a Haredi family in Jerusalem. It offers up beauty and depth and heart with its everyday stories of perfectly flawed humans, so unfamiliar on the outside, but so entirely relatable, full of shadow and light like all of us. The brilliance of this show is that it somehow completely unexpectedly takes habit, the mundane, the utterly ordinary, and transforms it with some intangible ingredient of alchemical magic. And so too it is with Beit Aleph. For an entire decade, impossibly, somehow you, Olivier, do the same for us. Your words ever broaden and enrich. You stand your own growth edge, offering your heart and soul and renewed insights, even if, as it's always the same, it also never is. And because of the fullness, the authenticity that you bring, we are challenged to stay conscious, awake to the things that matter. I'm so grateful for the teachings and the example that you are, because Lord knows I fall short just a little bit sometimes. So much admiration, hon, and so much love. And so we turn the page. Five, stand up for blessing. Baruch Hu Et Adonai Hamvorach, bless the eternal, the one who is blessing. Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Leolam Vaed, bless the eternal, the one who is blessing eternally. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Listen, Israel, the eternal manifest is all that is. The eternal is one. Baruch Shem Kivod Malchuto Leolam Vaed. Blessed is the name. The splendor of its presence shines eternally.
Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad. Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad. Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu
Sam McKagan, and I'm going to tell a short story, hopefully. So the first time I met Olivier was 9.5 years ago. so shortly after his ordination, at an interfaith conference in California. And my first memory of Olivier is it was the conference was over New Year's Eve, and New Year's Eve they had a big dance party. And I went to this dance party, and Olivier was there just rocking out and dancing for hours and hours. And I had wanted to go talk to him, but never really had a chance because he was too busy dancing. So at this conference, I had, at the time, I was not Jewish, not particularly interested in Judaism, but apparently searching for something spiritual because I was at an interfaith conference. And I also met two other members of Beit Aleph, Jamia and Madani. And Jamia, and we bonded over both all being from Seattle, and Jamia couldn't stop talking about Beit Aleph and how wonderful it was and how I needed to come and check it out. So I got back to Seattle and came. And the first service I went to was Olivier's first service as the head rabbi of Beit Aleph. And I don't remember what the Torah portion was, but I remember that it talked about monotheism and there being one God. And having grown up a fundamentalist Christian and rebelled against that, I really had never understood this obsession with there being one God. And the way that I had always understood it was like some weird obsession with counting. Like, why does it matter that we have one and you have many? And like, there's lots of ways to interpret God. And like, why does there being only one matter? And Olivier led us through sort of understanding this idea of there being one God as this mystical teaching of the oneness of everything. And that one God, there's only one God because all is one, and God is one, all is one, and he sort of led us through this meditation, and it just like, suddenly this thing that I had been struggling with all my life just like sunk in and made sense, and it was like, I was just home, and I kept going, and eventually converted to Judaism with Olivier, and it's just been an amazing journey of actually finding a spiritual home. And so I just wanna thank him for creating such a wonderful place. And we are going to say the Ve'ahavta, which is another reminder of connection with God and I can't do it justice, but we will say it. So turn to page 6 in your prayer book. Oh yeah, one more thing about the Ve'ahavta. So you can turn to page 6 in your prayer book. You can also read along here, and I didn't know this until I actually learned Hebrew, that the first line of this is the Shema, and then the rest of it is the first paragraph of the Ve'ahavta. And I was excited the first time I could read along with this, and then I got to the end and I was like, wait, where's the rest of it? So you can read along either place.
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol levavcha u'v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'adecha v'hayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anochi misadcha hayom alevavcha v'shinatam levavcha v'divartam ba'am v'shivtecha b'beitecha u'v'lechtecha v'aderech u'v'shochtecha u'v'kumecha u'v'shartam nevot ayotecha v'hayu letotafot bein einecha u'ktatam amizuzot b'techa uvishyarecha l'man tizkeru v'asitem et kol mitzvotai v'hitem kadoshim l'elohechem. Amen.
My name is Lowell Weiss, sort of a mixed metaphor of a name. I feel incredibly honored that Dianna asked me to say a few words here, but I do feel like I'm gonna undermine one of your important spiritual practices here of being egoless, as you talked about in the Torah reflection today, of moving toward a selflessness. But I'm gonna go for it anyway. As the spiritual guide Beyonce would say, sorry, not sorry. So my story starts 7 years ago, 3 years after your ordination, and I came first to Bet Aleph at a very vulnerable time. I had just gone through a divorce and I was sitting in the pews back here without my kids for the very first time at the High Holy Days since my kids were born. And it was a difficult time, and I felt insecure, I felt uncomfortable, I didn't know if I was in the right place. I had gotten the wonderful tip from the Terra Days, my neighbors, that Bet Aleph was a very special place, and I decided to try it at that moment. And from the first moment the service started, I knew, as Sam was saying, that I was home. That every single part of that service you used as a jumping off point, as a teachable moment, as a learning moment, not the rote version of Judaism and the rote version of services that I had grown up with, and I had, to use Sam's expression also, had rebelled against. And just the wisdom, the humor, the great accent, the great hair, everything about it felt right. Everything felt right. And I knew, through just one conversation with Shellie, you know, you had me at, you know, at the great accent. And so I became a member right away. And we've been through a lot together, and you have been, I feel sad that I'm just saying it up here for the first time, but I want you to know what an incredibly important part of our family you have been. And I'll just describe a little bit of that and some of the incredibly important moments in our life over the last 7 years you've been a central figure in. So from Sanders Bar Mitzvah, where Rabbi Olivier literally made house calls or houseboat calls, coming every Sunday from Kenmore to the houseboat where I was living at the time because it was sort of centrally located, made it very easy for me, to taking Sander and my mom to Israel for a trip that they will never forget, and a lot of phenomenal ping pong with Lior, Greek ping pong competition all over Israel, and the meditation retreat that I went on with my mother, which was a very, very meaningful experience for the two of us, to our wedding, which Rabbi Olivier and Amy flew in on a seaplane from Kenmore to Orcas Island, and you made an incredibly special, sorry Randy, but I think our service was even better, an incredibly special day helping to bring this blended family together in a really customized, very beautiful, very loving way, despite the fact that we had naked kids screaming in the background at Doe Bay Resort. If you've been there, you'll know what I'm talking about. And to my dad's passing and the way you really were with me in a very, very loving way through my dad's passing and his suffering and then passing to Michaela's bat mitzvah training. I mean, what an incredibly amazing thing it is that we have our rabbi who teaches the B'nai Mitzvah class. That is extremely rare. I was at a conference about 3 or 4 weeks ago in Amy's hometown in Minneapolis, and someone was presenting some data talking about, oh, I get to do what you do all the time. Awesome, I love it. somebody was presenting data on the happiness curve, and they were showing that the happiness curve really starts going up steeply at age 50. And in my experience, that I think that's actually right. That's around the corner for you. And in my case, I know exactly what to attribute that to. You know, having gotten a second chance at a loving connection and a loving partnership has been a big contributor. My dad no longer suffering, that's been a big contributor. And I know for sure that having the world's greatest rabbi has been an enormous contributor to that. So I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for being such a core member of our family, and I, you know, at some level adjunct member, but not really, really core member of our family. And being there with us in such an incredible way through so many important parts of our life, and I think most importantly for me, to be my most important spiritual mentor and guide. It has just been such an important part of my life, and I really thank you, and I'm so glad you decided that this was your calling, because it really is your calling. There's no doubt about it. So now my official responsibility is to be the lead-in to Erev Shel Shoshanim, and I know just two things about this. One is, of course, that this is one of Rabbi Olivier's favorite songs. And what Rabbi Google told me is that when this song is performed frequently in the Middle East, you can tell me if this is true, it is often accompanied by belly dancing. So I am going to belly dance. Just kidding, just kidding. You got very nervous there. Dianna has been my singing coach, not my belly dancing coach.
Shalom. I happen to love anything to do with words and learning about various languages. And I'm here to tell you that Olivier is one of the best in the business when it comes to language, whether it's teaching basic Hebrew or enriching the Torah for us by interpreting the wordplay and double meanings and the mystical meanings in the Torah. And there's another kind of language that we've been learning from our beloved rabbi, one that has no dictionary and no grammar book. It's the language of non-duality, the language that says God is one, there is no other, there is no separate self, we are all part of that one. It's a beautiful language. But it has its challenges because it doesn't have a vocabulary of its own. We have to use our Hebrew or English words, and we have to tweak them subliminally to get to the true meaning of what we're trying to say. Think about our most basic prayer, Baruch Atah Adonai. How many times a day do we say that? I'm supposed to say it 100, as Amy mentioned, but I have to ask myself, when I say that prayer, who am I actually speaking to? And what am I looking at? You know, if I'm speaking to a person, I'm looking at that person. if I'm saying you to God, God who manifests as all that is, where do I look? Do I look around me? Do I look upward towards the universe? Do I look inside, you know, my own divine essence? And there's another question. Why do we say, blessed are you, to God? I mean, that's already implying separation, the duality we're trying to grow out of. So shouldn't we be saying something more inclusive, like, blessed are we, Adonai? What would that be in Hebrew? Would it be Baruchim Anachnu? Yeah, okay, see, he's a good language teacher. Anyway, you can see how complicated this non-dual language can be, especially if you overthink it, which is what I often do. So until that glorious day when we won't need any words at all, we do the best we can with what we have. We ask Adonai, that's another word we could talk about, to open our lips so that we may declare the glory of the one manifest in all creation, the one who manifested as our early mothers and fathers, the one who manifests as each one of us, preparing to express our love and gratitude to the one and for the one that we are. Please rise for the Amidah, page 6.
And we're going to start with an Adonai Svatai chant. So please step into it once you sense the rhythm.
Adonai Svatai. Thank you.
ata Adonai Eloheinu Eloheinu Imoteinu Elohei Abraham Elohei Yitzhak Elohei Yaakov Elohei Sara Elohei Rivka Elohei Lea Elohei Rachel El Hagadol Gibor Vanora El Elyon Gomer Chasadim Tovim Vekone Hakol Zocher Hasde Avot Veimahot Umevi Geula Vivnei Vnehem Leman Shemo Ba'ava Melech Hozer Umoshiach Umagen Baruch Atah Adonai Magen Abraham Ezra Sara Atagi Bor Leolam Adonai Mechaye Hakol Ata Rav Lehoshia Mekorkel Chaim Bechesed Mechaye Hakol Berachamim Rabim Somech Novlim Berofet Olim Umatir asurim Umechayim emunato Lishene afar Michamocha al gebrot Umidomelach Melech meit Umechaye Umatzmiach Yeshua Ve'ne'eman Le'achrayot ha'kol Baruch atah Adonai Mechaye ha'kol.
Please be seated. Ready to jump around a little bit more? Another one of Olivier's favorite songs. It's called Kedushat Hayom, but most of us know it as Yis Mechu.
Shabbat. Yes, ma'am. Oh, healing. Change the energy just a little bit. I believe we are all on a healing journey. Sometimes it's the immediacy of our body not working well, or that we're in pain, physical pain. Often it's our minds and our negative thoughts that need attention. And sometimes our spirit needs guidance and support. Life is a narrow bridge. And in those most difficult times, it's often when we feel most alone, easily forgetting the essential truth that all is one. By making time and space each time we gather to focus on healing, to name and reach out to those in our community who are needing additional energy and support for their healing, we tighten the bonds between our individual healing journey and our community. We are reminded and we remember that we are not alone. We gather strength from each other. Dear Olivier, 10 years ago, there were doubting voices that said Bet Aleph wouldn't survive. One of your earliest commitments as a rabbi was to build and create a Bet Aleph in which the community was central. You were newly minted and so young. You were just finding your own voice, which has now come through so beautifully loud and clear. But even then, you were wise to know that this was the key piece of the healing that the community needed at that time. And it was my honor and privilege to partner with you, to do our best to actualize that commitment by involving the community in visioning and having people stay involved in its creation, which is ever evolving and continuing as we go forward. Over these 10 years, you have devoted yourself to Bet Aleph, all in. Your teachings have deepened our understandings, your leadership has guided, and you have brought lots of laughter and joy. Nobody's mentioned it yet, but somebody has to say something about Purim. That wasn't in there, but. Your steady presence has brought comfort, insights, and healing. You have supported many in sick beds, in mourning, in moments of crisis, along with many moments of joy. You have sat through the night reading Psalms, okay, while guarding the empty body of a loved one, including my mother. And how can we thank you for things like that? And then when you were the one in need, the community was there for you. I will always remember your first service back at the end, singing and dancing, I am alive. And the power of that awesome statement and realization. As I said to you, I don't know if you remember it because you were probably on a lot of drugs, but as I said to you in your in your hospital room, I would have been really pissed if you had died. We both had our near misses that year, and I am just so grateful that you are here now, and I am here to help celebrate you. Thank you for the opportunity to be your partner for 7 years in service to Bet Aleph, and I'm happy to publicly say back to you that I know for sure that I became a better leader, community builder, and person through our collaboration. Absolute best work partnership in my life. Thank you for all you have done and continue to do. Speaking for the community and for myself, you are so loved and respected. I love you, we love you, and what is more healing than love? So now, we turn our attention to the names of loved ones on the list, on the healing list. May the one who blessed our ancestors bless and heal all who are in need and bless all of us on our healing journeys, individually and as a community. Craig Wilson, Dan Klein, Daniel Clark, Hillary Wilson, Phyllis and Mike Levin, Farhan Hassan, Sarah Menser, Yitzhak Lieb, son of Bertha Aharon, Eva Ansel, Dave Malkoff, Maxwell Bernard, Hirsch Simon, Susanna Davis, Karen Lindquist, Patty Chemnick, Stella Altweis, Elizabeth Heath, David Mark, Pietra Zemski, Mike Wald, Shelley Cohn, Millard Petersky, Dan Glosser, Colleen Roughton, sorry if I'm mangling names, Fred Cohen, and if there are other names of people that you know who are on the list, let us all keep them in our hearts for healing.
You answer me from your For much of my adult life, before we found Bet Aleph, there was an ache to the fact that I had a Jewish life and I had a spiritual life, but the two seemingly had nothing to do with each other. For the first decade of our marriage, before we found Bet Aleph, David and I celebrated Jewish holidays, sent our kids to Sunday school, and attended life cycle events in various different Jewish communities. The ones that had held enough tradition to resonate with David's Reform Jewish background were not funky enough to resonate with my secular Jewish background. And in true Jewish fashion, even the ones that resonated with one of us did not fully meet either of our needs. So when a friend told me about Bet Aleph, I was curious. In the middle of the first service David and I attended, in the middle of the first of Rabbi Olivier's talks we ever heard, it was somewhere around the part where he conjectured that the authors of that part of the Torah, what the authors of that part of the Torah were trying to achieve. We looked at each other, smiled, and nodded, and wondered if we had found our place. Nearly a decade later, I'm glad to say that that moment of hope, that perhaps we had found our Jewish home, our Jewish spiritual home, has come to fruition. In Bet Aleph, we have found a community of people who come with open hearts, perhaps better said as opening hearts, who want to be here. We are challenged to learn, to expand, to think, to act, to see the holiness in ourselves and each other. We are allowed, we are invited to wrestle with God, to wrestle with the idea of God. This is a place where we can wrestle with the politics of Israel. We are inspired to wrestle with our own thoughts, our own perceptions, and the world around us, and to do something with what we discover. Intellectual honesty, spirit, community, so worth the 18-mile drive from Issaquah. Speaking of wrestling, for someone who grew up with a secular Jewish background, raised in a lay-led community founded by my aunt and uncle, even the idea of having a rabbi has been a challenge for me. My previous experience with rabbis had not inspired me to go and get one of my own. Rabbi Olivier is the first rabbi I have ever referred to, or would ever refer to, as my rabbi. I'm not sure I've made it so easy for him. There's a fair amount of wrestling that I do, and he has met that with openness, honesty, warmth, and humor. I am only one of many of us, and I trust he has met each one of us where we are with compassion and with love. For your leadership, for your sharing your own wrestling with us and our children, for your passion, and for all that you pour into this community, I thank you and I celebrate you. Are we rising for the Elenu? Okay. Please rise for the Elenu.
Alleluia l'shabeach l'adon ha'kol la'teik gila yotzer reshit shelo asanu pigoye ha'baratzot ve'lo asamaru k'mishkot ha'adama shelo san kelkenu kahem ve'kohor aleinu k'chol ha'mona Tachabim umodim lifnei melech malchei hamalachim hakadosh baruch hu ve'ne'emar v'haya Adonai lemelech al kol ha'aretz v'yom ha'hu v'yom ha'hu.
Please be seated.
Oh, how do you stand under that light? So a few days ago, I got an email asking if I would say a few words about one of the prayers and about Olivier tonight. And I send back, sure, I can do that, no problem. And then I get another email saying, okay, you're going to come up and talk about the Kaddish and introduce that. And I'm like, seriously? Okay, my favorite. When I first came to Beit Aleph, many years ago, and we came to the part of the Kaddish, I didn't get it. I'm like, what are they talking about here? This is supposed to be, we're a mourners. It has mourners right in the title. What are they talking about, praise and glory and all this? I don't get it. I'm sad. I'm in grief. I'm mourning someone who has passed. I'm mourning a piece of me that is maybe gone, or I've let go by choice. It's still mourning. Why are we celebrating this? I didn't get it. So through some time, talking to the rabbi on and on and off and on and off and on and off again, what I came to understand, first off, the rabbi's teaching was, Cindy, just keep saying it. Just keep coming. Just keep meeting it. Say it again. Say it again. And through time and patience and the loving kindness that the rabbi taught me to have towards myself, I figured out that grief, and this is, I'm just using a really broad brush here. I'm talking about me because that's my favorite subject. Grief is about disorientation. You don't know where you are, don't know where I am. And the Kaddish gave me something to hold on to, a firmness, a firm footing, a location where I could just hold on and remember. Words in the Kaddish that spoke to me, life and blessing, they're repeated throughout that. It reminded me, I'm alive. I'm still here, and I'm being blessed every single day, every single moment. And the person that I'm thinking of or holding in my heart or the part of me that I'm grieving, they were alive, and they were blessed every moment. Words like peace show up in the prayer, reminding me and reminding us that no matter what disorientation, what confusion, the depth of our grief, the depth of our chaos, peace is possible. If only for that moment when you say the word, there you are. And lastly, the fact of that the words are ancient words. They've been spoken over time, millennia. Who knows how old truly? And it reminds me like of a spiritual handshake. Or maybe better, not a handshake, a hand clasp. Or that gentle touch on my shoulder from the past, reminding me, you're not in this alone. This is part of being human. We're here with you now, in the future. Whenever we're in that place of grief for others, for ourselves, or for a place, a time. So acknowledging our humanness, acknowledging our connection, acknowledging peace, love, and blessing, that's what I've come to understand the Kaddish to mean. And to that I say amen. Okay. Read the list first? Yeah. Okay. Okay. Thank you. For passing in the past 30 days, Dr. John, Lynn Carroll's friend, Macy Yule. For those that have made their transition in the past 12 months, Ludek Elias, Nordy Cuban, Ira Moss, Jeff Timoney, Jerry Todd, A.J. Thompson, Timothy Bruce Lyons, John Corney, Gordon Reeve Gould, Carl Heller, Steve Dorn, Julian Samuel Ansel, Demetrius Oliver Sullivan, Murray Bernard, for those whose anniversary of their transition, their yard site happens at this time of the year, Clint Loper, Ruth Duskin Feldman, Saul Mark, Hugh Capel Dorshek, Jeffrey Feldman, Bennett Marks, Harriet Simon, Dr. Peter Siegler, Marion Sofren, Steve Wise, Jose Marie Ramos, and for those that we hold in our hearts whose names are not on our list today, we acknowledge their passing and the love. Please join us on page 13 for the Mourner's Kaddish.
Yet Hadar, Yet Dale, Yet Halal, Shemay, the Kucha, Varifu. The Elam in Kol Birchata, the Shemata, Tush the Chata, the Nechemata, the Amiram, the Alma, the Iru, Amen. Yehe Shalama Rabba Min Shemaya, the Chaim Aleinu, the Akol Israel, the Iru, Amen. Ose Shalom bin Ramav, Uyaaseh shalom, aleinu ve'akol Yisrael, ve'akol yoshvei tevel, ve'imru amen. May the one who creates harmony above make peace for us, for all the household of Israel, and for all the peoples of the world, and let us say,
we're going to move on to the priestly blessing. And we're going to do this in two stages. First, we're going to sing a song, or you can listen to the song. There's a part of the song that says Shalom, and you'll know right where to step in.
It's the only part I know.
And then there will be part two of the blessing, and I'll explain that after the song.
Thank you. shalom, 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 ve'asim lecha shalom, ve'asim lecha shalom, ve'asim lecha shalom.
Part two of the priestly blessing. Olivier, if you could come up to the bima. And I think everybody knows the Vulcan sign. I know my son and I are not the only Star Trek fans in the house. All right, the blessings. On page 14, we are going to start with the Yivarechicha, and I want everybody to put up the sign of blessing, and I want you to put your prayer shawl.
Good.
Face forward and receive. Yivarechicha Adonai v'yishmerecha. Ya'er Adonai pana elecha v'chuneka. Yisa Adonai pana v'lecha v'yasem lecha shalom. And in English, the Eternal One blesses and keeps you always. The light of the Eternal Presence shines upon you with grace. The Eternal Presence awakens within you and brings you peace. Amen. Please be seated. Do we have Karen in the house?
Shalom, everybody. I know I can only speak for myself, but I know I'm not the only one that was overwhelmed by the heartfelt stories that were shared tonight in services. So thank you to all of you who participated and made this so special. It's just a testament to how our rabbi has touched your lives and all of our lives. And so thank you all. We have a lot to celebrate here at Bet Olive. By the way, I'm Karen Warner, and for those of you who don't know me, I'm the director here. And if this is your first service, or if it's your first service in a very long time, and you have questions about Bet Olive, come find me downstairs at the Oneg. And speaking of Oneg, if you were unable to make our pre-neg before services, please do not miss our Oneg afterwards. It will be much more to celebrate after, so please join us downstairs. And speaking of celebrations, they continue with tomorrow morning here in our sanctuary as Audrey Porad Brand is called to the Torah as a B'nai Mitzvah. So we'll have services here at 10:30. Please join us. And we have our annual Bet Olive meeting Sunday in the Friedel Hall, the Friedel Room, I should say. And that's from 3 to 5. We do need a quorum, and we will vote in our slate of board of directors and hopefully approve our annual budget, and you get to hear from staff and our board and our rabbi. So, and whatever is not eaten at Oneg, I'm sure you might see on Sunday. So please be there. And we have our Interfaith Climate Action is having carbon offsetting information meetings, both on Sunday, June 16th at 12:30, or Friday before our services, June 21st at 6:30 p.m. Come learn about carbon credits. And if you want to hear more tonight, Keith, wave your hand. Go find him at Oneg. And if you loved our music tonight, you'll really appreciate our next service, which is Music Shabbat, Friday, June 21st. So find us here. We're all excited. and save the date next month for our annual community picnic, which will be at Seward Park, 4 p.m. till dusk, and we'll have fun and be by the water and have a potluck, and you'll hear more about it later, but save the date for next month. And we look forward to having all of you here. And again, just we look forward to continuing celebrations at ONEG downstairs.
Do you have the counting the Omer? Karen?
Karen.
Karen. The counting the Omer.
Oh.
Then you can leave it. Go for it. Yes, you are. If you need to know what day we're on, I'm sure the rabbi can give you a hint. No? No? Oh, you're going to figure it out.
Okay. am I starting with the prayer?
Yes.
Okay.
It's not the 48.
It's the what?
It's not the 48, nor the 50.
Okay, thank you. perfect. So if everyone will join me. Do you have these sheets in your prayer book? Because I'm not going to be reading this by myself. So for counting the Omer. Thanks, Dianna. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher shanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu al sfirat ha-Omer. Blessed is the 49th.
Comprising of seven weeks.
7 weeks of the Omer. Yay! This is it. That's it. Thanks. Okay. We did a beautiful job, everybody.
Please be seated. I actually have an announcement to add to the list. As some of you know, because you helped me out on this, with the help of contributions of about a dozen of our members, I put together a 10-year anniversary book for you. Alas, it just shipped today. So what I'm hoping is going to work out right after we do our concluding song, the screen in the library, I'm going to connect my computer to it, go online where we can all see it virtually so we can all enjoy it there together. And then it's going to arrive and it will be here for the music Shabbat and many Shabbats after for people to enjoy. So I'm sorry I didn't get here today because that was the goal. But when it does arrive, I will bring it to you, but hopefully we'll have a moment to all be in the library room and see it virtually together. And I just want to say a couple of quick words myself. So I've been working with Olivier, well, singing the whole 10 years, and I don't even know when I became music director. Maybe six or seven years ago, you know, give or take. And it's been an amazing journey. We've had our twists and our turns, and but I think that's because we both feel so passionate about what we do here. And there was always a forward momentum, and we've gelled, and we get to the point where, which is, I think, where we wanted to be, where we finish each other's sentences, or I think of a song, and he says, how about this song? I'm like, oh my God, we're just thinking of that song. Or I come up with an idea, and he's like, yes, that's what I was thinking, that kind of thing. Which really makes it fun and easy, and there's spontaneity, and we get to the point now where we can have what actually a lot of jazz musicians have, where they can communicate on stage just by a look, and they know exactly what's going to happen next in the song and the improv and the jam session, and we have evolved to that point, and it is truly a joy. So we are going to sing the concluding song, Ergo, there is a concluding. And this was another request of Olivier's. First time you've done it, although it should be familiar to many of you. It's called Jerusalem of Gold.
Avir harim tzalul kamayim v'reach oranim nisa beruach ha'arbayim im kol ha'amonim uftardem matilan va'even shvuya b'chalomah Ha'ir asher ayanan yoshevet ubeliba choma Yerushalayim shel zahar v'shel nechoshet v'shel or Halo lechol shirayich ani kinov Yerushalayim shel zahar
One more time, sorry.
Thank you. Mazel tov, Mazel tov, Simen tov, Simen tov, Mazel tov, Mazel tov, Simen tov, Simen tov, Mazel tov, Mazel tov, Simen tov, Yehelanu. Simen tov, Mazel tov, Mazel tov, Simen tov, Simen tov, Mazel tov, Mazel tov, Simen tov, Simen tov, Mazel tov, Mazel tov, Simen tov, Yehelanu.
See you in time.